violent and sudden inflation, from darkness to our current bright night sky. A mighty event that's at the birth of our universe. Not just a tiny moment in time, but a still ongoing event of creation. As of today, we will see the expansion of our universe that was once created by the Big Bang. In this two-part special, we will dive into the moment this dramatic event took place, and we'll theorize what was before the creation of our known universe. It's all about before and after the Big Bang. Our universe contains the most dramatic and beautiful things you can imagine. We have billions of stars, planets, galaxies, and dust clouds in all sizes and different matter. From the bright sun to black holes, it all came together in one epic event. Some things aren't even possible for us humans to put into perspective. 13.8 billion years ago, the birth of our universe took place, an event we call the Big Bang. It's an explanation of how our universe was created. Before we go on this violent journey, we must understand what a singularity is. This is an event in which property is infinite, just like a black hole. The more gravity you have in a location, the more it bends space. When you bend space, you also bend the distance between point A and B. Bending point A and B would also bend time. If there is so much gravity in one place, very strange things start to happen. Gravity is crushing everything into such a dense state. This is called infinite gravity. Gravity is pulling everything into an infinite density. You now have a singularity, a mind-bending event in which the current laws of physics do not apply anymore to this region of space. Our universe was once a very small singularity, before it stretched over 13.8 billion years to the universe we can now observe. The Big Bang was not an explosion, but an event in which space expanded out of an infinite singularity. To this current day, our known universe is still stretching. Edwin Hubble figured out that other galaxies formed by the Big Bang were moving away from our galaxy. The galaxies that are further away from us move faster than the ones that are close to us. It means that the universe is still expanding. We know everything around our solar system moves away. So at one point, everything had to be very, very close together. But let's go back to the beginning. Because everything was extremely close together, it was a very hot place. At the start of this Big Bang, we have had a dramatic moment which we call Planck time. This is 10 million trillion 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 trillions of a second. At this moment, the temperature reached 100 million trillion trillion degrees. Within a second, the universe expanded very fast. After that second, the temperature cooled down to 100 billion degrees. After just 1 second, all the matter created by this event were protons and neutrons. It only took about 13 seconds before the temperature dropped further to 3 billion degrees. We fast forward to 700,000 years later, an important moment in which the temperature dropped enough to form the first atoms, the building block for ordinary matter. Atoms can merge together to create molecules that form almost anything around us. But how do we know all of this? It's not like we had first row seat tickets to watch this unimaginable event happen. It's like a water drop that falls in the water. We study the ripples created in the water to understand where this ripple originated from. Scientists study everything around us to understand at which point this event took place. An important part in the understanding of the Big Bang is the speed in which galaxies are moving. Some galaxies move at unbelievably high speeds of at least 100,000 kilometers a second. When you look far away in the universe, there's so much more you can see. You can even go back in time. humans made highly advanced telescopes, which are able to see very far. When the universe was created by the Big Bang, this sudden expansion created an enormous amount of light scattering through the universe. Because our universe is stretching, the light is stretched into microwaves. With a microwave telescope, we are able to observe ancient light all the way back to the beginning of our universe. Light plays a vital role in understanding when everything we know was created. We have these telescopes so we can look at space billions of light years away. Because it takes so long for light to reach us, we are looking into the past and are seeing the dust clouds created by the Big Bang as if it just happened. We have a lot of tools to make complex mathematical equations that explain the burning question of how our universe was created. But why aren't we able to see the exact start of the Big Bang, just like the clouds we are able to see 13 billion light years away? Let's use our imagination. You're standing on Earth, but there is no light. It's completely dark. No way for your eyes to adjust. The sun is the start of the universe. But the sun also has no light. You are literally observing the start of our universe in darkness. At the creation of our universe, there was no light. Light literally didn't exist yet. So, we will never be able to see the start of our universe. It's hidden behind the clouds of darkness. It's still a difficult thing to realize that all started from nothing. Because what is before nothing? If you identify nothing, isn't it then automatically something? In the next episode, we will theorize what happened before the Big Bang. Feel free to subscribe so you don't miss the next part. Thank you for watching. We have given you a small look into this subject. We might have missed something. We might have gotten something wrong. Let us know what your thoughts are. We hope you stay around for another episode. Only if you like this video, please subscribe to see more episodes.